First, the sanity break in the tweet of the day, and this is about the nonsense about Bristol Palin admitting abstinence doesn't work and getting bent out of shape because I said abstinence doesn't work, from Sabrina Brown. Aw, Keith, Bristol is pissed at you. To Ms. Brown and Ms. Palin, I worked for ESPN for a total of 7.5 years. Bristol is pissed at me is my default setting. First, get out your pitchforks and torches. Time for today's nominees for the worst persons in the world. But our winners, once again, the Writers and Veterans Committee, who elect the members of baseball's Hall of Fame. Between his debut in 1960 and the end of his career in 1974, Ron Santo of the Chicago Cubs hit 342 home runs and drove in 1,331 runs, more than anybody else in that era who did not play first base or the outfield. In 13 full seasons as a third baseman, he won the Gold Glove as the best fielder at his position 5 times. The first year he was eligible for the Hall of Fame, the writers gave Santo 4% of their vote. After 18 years, they were all the way up to 43%. Getting in is 75%. The Veterans Committee, which is supposed to correct the writers' many mistakes, never did. Ron Santo died last night at the age of 70, one of the top 10 third basemen in history, and he never got to hear the words, "You've been voted into the Hall of Fame, Ron." The electors of the Baseball Hall of Fame, whose voting has all the validity of sending in the most box tops from cereal packages. Today's worst persons in the world.